The nice thing about an ASMR video, in my opinion, is that I can just ramble about very boring stuff and no one minds, because the whole point is that it's supposed to be very relaxing, and there's nothing more relaxing than some old bore droning on about their hobby, eh? So that was Hydra, that was number two. The third one in the series is Werewolf. Let's see, I saw Werewolf not long ago, struggling to remember what colour I have him in. Let's see, most of this video will just be me like trying to file through all these, which means as we go on it'll probably go quicker because I'll have a better idea where stuff is. The werewolf. Now, I am using my ring light for the first time for this. I know a ring light is supposed to be for someone's face, but I'm using it for these guys just to get used to lighting and stuff, because I'm still using my old iPhone that's got a terrible cracked screen. So I've basically just reset the iPhone to factory settings, and I'm just using it as a camera and a hard drive until such time I can get a proper camera. So that was Werewolf and another green one. Next up, we're looking for Behemoth, whichever way you would want to say it. So again, I saw him a second ago, and I've got... The thing about these figures is, if you collect them for any length of time, you end up with more than one colour, many more than one. So here we have Behemoth, and he is a very good one. He's one that people really like, I think. I like him a lot. He's one I remember from childhood. And this one is the... Let's see, I always find it difficult. I would say those are both kind of light purples, but I think Behemoth is the light purple. Behemoth, and Behemoth is number four. And next up, we will be looking for Griffin, and there's Griffin. Oh, it's another green one. My experience tells me that green is easy. Like, it seems like there's a multitude of green figures out there, and I would say that in my collection I have more green than anything. And now next we are looking for a dinosaur later on. Oh, it's another green one. I'm sure I have this guy in other colors, but this is Tyrannosaurus Rex. Not really a monster. See, the great thing about this series is almost all of the characters, except the T-Rex, are based on legends and myths, or literature even, but they're all kind of from gothic fiction or legends or folklore, and obviously I haven't said too much about them so far, but what can you say about the T-Rex? Caused a scene in Jurassic Park. Of cockatrice piece. Oh, there's another great beast. It's another green one, but I'll show you the difference in the greens. So there's, on your left, you've got neon green, and on your right, you've got olive green. And to think people would spend hundreds of pounds to get these variants. So yeah, we're looking for cockatrice. I have no idea about the origins of cockatrice. And once again, that's if I was just talking about it. Here's another green one. And it's, this is cockatrice. And I'm not sure what the myth or legend there is. If anyone's interested, you could probably find it online. If I was a proper toy YouTuber, like someone like Dan Larson at Toy Galaxy, I would tell you a lot more about these as we go, probably. But hopefully you're falling asleep right now and I'm just boring you to death. That would be ideal. So next up, we've got number 8, who is Cyclops. So it's a winged panther, it's a zombie. Where is the Cyclops? Come on, man. Help me out a little bit here. Got a bunch of witches. Oh no, I've just had a low power warning on my iPhone. Maybe we don't have time for this. That is not a Cyclops. So if this video ends suddenly, you will know why. So Cyclops has his arm held out. So I'm looking for... Oh, I really should have planned this a lot better. Maybe we'll come back to the Cyclops. So the next one is number 9, which is... just give up on trying to do them in order, because I have just thrown them out in a pile because I thought it would look cool with all the colors. So let's not do them in order. Let's just do them as they come. So here we've got Bigfoot. And Bigfoot, let's see, he is number 17. That's another green one. Now this guy. Salt and see what his name is. Oh, come on, pal. What's your name? Oh, I hope you can't hear my neighbors downstairs. They are the worst. This guy is called Rock, R-O-C. That's a purple one. Now here we have, Cerberus. This is Cerberus. And you all kind of, if you've seen Harry Potter, you know a little bit about who Cerberus is. Three-headed dog. Guards. Is it the Gates of Hell? I don't know. Not in Harry Potter. You're the witch. She is just called witch. She is one of the way more common figures. And I have so many of witch all over the place. I think I may have almost all the colors. I'm not even going to do the numbers anymore, because honestly, I think my battery's going to run out. And so I'll go to my favourite figure. This is Spring-Heeled Jack. So, whenever I started collecting these, well, whenever I restarted collecting these during the last lockdown last summer, my personal goal was to get one of every sculpt. I didn't really care about the colours, but I wanted all the colours of Spring-Heeled Jack. And I just recently finished that off with this guy. He is Pine Green Spring-Heeled Jack, which is a premium rare one. And it goes for a lot of money apparently on So I'm very pleased with that. I've got all the spring heel jacks now. Another favorite from series one for many people is Ghost. Ghost is very cool with his decapitated head. That was another kind of personal goal I set, to get all the colors of Ghost. But because it is such a cool sculpt, it seems like everyone in the world has set themselves that goal. So the prices are high. Okay, so this one is Kali, K-A-L-I. Now, some of these, in inverted commas, monsters are not so much monsters as they are kind of religious icons. That becomes much more of an issue in series two, which, if you like this video, I will do series two as well, which has less figures and maybe more interesting, because there was some controversy about it. Here is Medusa. Of course, if you Medusa stared at you, or you stared at her, looked at her, you'd be turned to stone because of those, not because of the snakes in her hair, but what's the whole deal with the snakes in the hair? Is that a stone? What's that to do with the stone? Here is the monster, as in Frankenstein's, but in this series I believe he is just called the monster. He's a favourite sculpt of mine, and this is the neon red version of the monster. Pretty cool. Let's see, there is a purple ghost. I've got a few ghosts actually. I'm nowhere near the whole set of ghosts, but maybe someday. We've got a mummy here. This is the mummy. It's another cool one. I really sat down to just be like, let's do this almost semi-professional, do it in order and everything. And I got the low battery warning, and oh, it's just all gone to hell in a handbasket. There is another mummy. That's the purple mummy. I think purple, he looks better in purple. The more the detail and the sculpt. The sculpts are very good. Can you see the detail? And these are tiny little figures as well. They all have numbers on the back as well, because there was a game you could play with them if you wanted to. Now this guy, let me think, because there's a few which are kind of humanoid and all share this kind of pose. I think this is the Phantom. Let me just check. Pretty sure this is the Phantom. Is it? Yes, this is the Phantom, number 38. Look at that. Look at the look on his face. Always happy chappy. Look at that. There's another Phantom. This guy, I think his name is Caliban. Let me just check. I want to say his name is Caliban. No, it's not. I'm thinking of the Tempest. His name is Charon, or Sharon, or Sharon. His name is Sharon. He's a very common figure. I feel like every time I buy a bundle of these on eBay, I get two or three of him. This one's got some staining. So, like, one of the things about these figures is that whenever you store them, you have to, you've got to keep them separated by color, because some of the colors can bleed onto the others. So if you have light colors like the neon yellow or regular yellow, or God forbid the glow in the dark ones, and you store them with anything that's, I think mostly it's red, neon red and orange, they will stain, they will like bleed in, and there's no way to get that out. No way at all. So, let's have a look. Now this is, this is Zombie. Pretty sure it's Zombie. Let me just check, I'm doubting myself all over the place here. Yeah, that's Zombie, and he is number 29. This is the neon red version of him. This is actually a little bit dirty. whenever I get them in, I tend to clean them with a toothbrush and then a toothpick. But that's what happens when you're in lockdown from coronavirus. You have time enough to do such things. Maybe I got him in the second lockdown where I had more to do with my time. There's another spring-heeled jack, actually. That's the olive green spring-heeled jack. That's a double. So I can probably put him in my doubles pile. Another cockatrice. We've already done him. So what about this chap? Now this is supposedly a manticore. Let's have a look at that beautiful face. Now it's not the manticore you might expect if you've seen Onward in the last year, which I highly recommend. That's a great movie. But this is not the same kind of manticore, is it? Oh, welcome to your nightmares. Check him out. Alright. There's another phantom. There's another mummy. There's another Cerberus. Sharon. See you later, Sharon. Oh, there's one we haven't done. This is a harpy. Now, have you seen Jason and the Argonauts? Again, this isn't what I think of a harpy looking like, but it's still a very cool design, I think. It's difficult the way I have this light set up. It's difficult to get a good angle on the camera. But yeah. This is one that everyone loves, I think. This is the mad scientist. He's very cool. Check him out. The sculpting on these is so good. And they are, like, there's my thumb. That's how big they are. God, I need a manicure, eh? Now this beautiful creature. Let's find out his name, because I can never forget it. It's Baba Yaga. Now, unless I'm really mistaken, there is an X-Files episode, one of the later ones, about the Baba Yaga. And it is a disturbing, weird episode. But I could be wrong. It might not, I might just be making that up. That's Baba Yaga. And, this is Tengu. I'm pretty sure this is Tengu. This is the one that I couldn't find at the beginning, so just started moving on. So this is number 9, Tengu. No idea what his backstory is, but he's a weird little dog creature with wings. Dog, he's not a dog, he's like a goblin or something. I don't know. This is the Beast. Again, a really common figure in my experience. Seem to find him a lot. Got a lot of the Beast. Alright, now what is this guy's name again? Kutlikyu. I don't know. Someone can correct me if anyone's still listening. Kutlikyu, Kuatlikyu. I don't want to say what it looks like. I don't want to really comment on what any of these could be, because it could be something from a distant culture that I'm not familiar with, and people could take offense. So I won't say anything. I'm trying to remember the name of this guy. I just want to say he's called Skeleton. He is. This is just called Skeleton. Simple little one. He's kind of wobbly because they are just made of very soft rubber. You can see that they move around, and this one especially, because Sometimes has a trident, sometimes doesn't, and as you can imagine, there's a big price difference between certain colors that have the trident and certain colors that don't have the trident, and yada yada yada. So it goes. And the next one on the list is Kraken. And I thought I knew there's a Kraken there. So that is Kraken. This handsome fellow. Hello. Hello. How you doing? Yeah. So that's Kraken. That's number 11, I think. Number 12 is the Jotun Troll. Hello to this many-faced thing. Beautiful, eh? Now, there is, I think, maybe the rarest monster in my is a Jotun Troll that has a star on its back instead of a number. It was part of some kind of promotion. I'm not an expert in these things, but I know more than most people on the street, I guess. But if you have some monsters in my pocket and you find a Jotun Troll with a star on its back, you might want to get on that, guys, because it's worth, I think at this point, maybe around £1,000. The last time I saw one go on eBay. So yeah. Now the next monster we're looking for is called Karnak. I'm going to try to go back in order. See if I can find Karnak, who looks a certain way. Hello, Karnak, are you there? I need you. I want to show the people. Is that you? No, that's the Cyclops. Oh, we were looking for Cyclops earlier on. That is Cyclops. Okay, so we finally got to Cyclops. Now let's see if we can find Karnak. Again, I'm sure there will be some watching this, you can see Karnak in amongst all these, and we'll be saying, he's right there in front of you, you fool. Is that him? That's another Tengu. It's another Tengu. Okay, let's come back to Karnak. So the next one we haven't done yet is a winged one. Let's find the ones with wings. Oh, dropped one. So this is called Catoblepas. Catoblepas. I'm sure I'm pronouncing that wrong, but again, look at the sculpt on that face. That is great. These were from, I think, 1991. Again, like soft rubber. Look at that. That's awesome. So next one we're looking for is this handsome boy, Hanover. I'm sure my pronunciation of these is terrible, but this is Hanover. And he is very cool as well. With that big nose and those big ears. He's kind of like a big gremlin face. So next one on the list is Hobgoblin. Let's see if we can find Hobgoblin. I'm still looking for, oh, there's Karnak. I found him. There's Karnak right there. Hello, Karnak. You rotter. I see you. Okay, so we're looking for Hobgoblin now. Is that him? No, that's not him. Fun. Excellent. Hello, Wendigo. Excellent. Look at you. Beautiful. And then we have Red Cap. Red Cap is another one that I have found to be really common. I say that and then I won't be able to put my hand on him probably. Where are you? Red Cap. Come on. What is going on? This is supposed to be a monstrous 666 video. There's Red Cap there. Look at that face. Hello. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you and your family. When, by when. Don't worry. No, I won't. Red Cap might, but probably not since he is less than 1 inch tall. Saw Medusa, didn't we? Medusa was number 26. And then next we have Goblin. This is Hobgoblin and Goblin. This is Goblin. And that is, I've got a green Goblin. Yeah, pretty cool. That is Goblin. We've already done Cerberus, we've already done Zombie. Where is Chimera? Do you know, I might have actually passed off a Chimera as a Cerberus. See, that is a Cerberus. And that is a Chimera. They're not the same, but you can see how you would confuse them in a big pile, eh? So that is the Chimera. And Chimera is number 30. We've already done Ghost. And next one at number 32. Is the ogre, which is this friendly man. Hello. Hello, ogre. Where is the vampire? We need a vampire. There's a vampire. Oh, see, as we go on now, there's less on the table, so I'm finding more. Not your traditional vampire. Those ears. Quite camp. Just like, oh no, don't even look at me, stop papping me, don't you know who I am? So that is a vampire. Oh, check out that face, beautiful. We've already done Rock. Now let's see if we can find Gremlin, who's number 35. Again, any minute now this camera is going to cut out, I'm sure of it. Actually, you know what, we might get this video done if I can find everything. So where is Gremlin? Is that Gremlin? This is Gremlin. That is Gremlin. Come on, Gremlin. Be cool. There he is. It's a neon red Gremlin. Lady Vampire, the Vampiress, is next at number 36. So where are you, Vampiress? Where the hell are you? Oh, there she is. Always get her mixed up with Medusa. Got very similar body shapes, I think. There she is. Then we've got the ghoul. The ghoul who's a little baldy man with an axe. There he is. Oh dear. It's gonna be me in about 5 years' time, I think. Going to Tesco. Trying to get my dinner. We've already done the Phantom, who was number 38, and the Mad Scientist, who's number 39. Winged Panther is number 40. That's not Winged Panther. This is Winged Panther, who is, unsurprisingly, panther with wings. The more you know. Then Mummy was number 41. We've already had a look at Mummy. I can't see one immediately. We've already seen Sharon. There's Sharon again. Sharon was number 42. The Beast was number 43, which was 44. My favorite spring-heeled Jack was number 45. The Invisible Man is number 46, and this is another very cool one. I always really liked the Invisible Man. He's very cool. Check him out. Skeleton was number 47, and finally, number 48 on the checklist. If I can find him, here's one. Is the Hunchback. There he is, old Quasimodo. Looking very handsome. So, that is more or less series one of Monster in My Pocket, the Matchbox. Monster in My Pocket that were released in the UK in the early 90s. I by no means have a complete set of all the colours. I don't really want that. I just wanted all the characters. But at some point I might show you all of my Spring-Heeled Jacks. There's 8, I think. I've got 8 of them all in the different colours. They're very cool. And I have some of the glow-in-the-dark ones too. So my personal collecting goals, I started last summer during lockdown, to get one of each character from series 1 and 2, to get all the colours of Spring-Heeled Jack, then to maybe get all the colours of Ghost, until I realised how expensive that would be, to get all the colours of Ectoplasmic Phantom from series 2, which I have also achieved, and to get all the glow-in-the-dark figures, and I've got maybe 2/3 of those, so I'm quite close to kind of finishing what I want from a Monster in My Pocket collection. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you found it relaxing. No gum chewing this time, just whispering and fiddling around with toys. And yeah, lots of monsters. So thank you all for subscribing, for liking, for commenting. I really appreciate it. I started this channel in 2018. I didn't think I would get any more than maybe 50 subscribers, and I got something like 200 or 300 really, really quickly. And then life got in the way, and some bad things happened, and I kind of didn't have the motivation anymore to do this, and didn't pay attention. And then just recently, logged into YouTube Studio and saw that even while I wasn't doing anything, that people were still watching and people were still subscribing, and that somehow with me doing literally nothing, that I reached over 600 subscribers. So that is amazing to me. I want to thank everyone that subscribed while I was away. I'm back now. I can't promise I'll be back forever, because I'll be back to work soon after this lockdown, but I'm going to try my best to keep it more regular, because I'm really enjoying doing this. I really enjoy being in contact with you guys, and I'm hoping in the next week, some point next week, maybe this weekend, to do videos on some books and some music, and I might even try to tag some other YouTubers in those and see if they're interested in following my lead with some of the themes that I'll be covering. But thank you very much for watching. I hope you are, I kind of just hope you're asleep now, really. Sleep, either asleep or just super relaxed. But don't go on eBay thinking that it's a good idea to get into Monster in My Pocket. Before you do that, go and research what these things are worth, in inverted commas, to collectors. Because you can get a collection like mine for next to nothing if you go in the right places. But if you go on eBay, you might end up paying a lot more than you bargained for. So anyway, good night guys. Thank you very much for listening and watching. See you later.